title of the section and the description of the session. So I will make a few comments on long-term investment. Then I will discuss the problem of long-term investment in Southeastern Europe, and I will draw some policy implications for Greece. In the past, when we used to talk about long-term investment, people had in mind large-scale projects. In recent years, we moved more to long-term investors. So long-term investment is really about commitment, is about time frame, and is about engage of capital in a country. It's interesting to look at post-crisis trends and post-crisis trends in emerging economies, because they are relevant to what we discuss here. First, a major beneficial of global liquidity has been large multinationals from developing countries, from emerging economies. While when it comes to projects, infrastructure, green economy, etc., the funding gap still persists. We have seen also smart investors being more selective and discriminative against countries. And finally, it is clear that the environment is becoming less favorable as we move forward. What is the situation in Southeastern Europe when it comes to long-term investment? We need to draw a line before and after the crisis. When you look after the crisis, investors are less optimistic about the policy scenario and the growth scenario of Southeastern Europe. When it comes to growth, when it comes to economic integration, when it comes to the quality of institutions, all the data kind of reach the conclusion that the policy scenario of Southeastern Europe growing at 6% is no more the case. We are talking about much lower growth rates and a risk-averse investors' perception for this part of the world. Are there any upside? Is there any future? There are certain elements of upside driving in a way. One is that these economies are catching up economies, so they will eventually grow. Second, there are investment opportunities in what you call growth and regional integration corridors. Another thing is that we see that mid-caps in this region really gain and grasp the benefits of consolidation at the sectoral level. And finally, we see that in this region, because of the EU, because EIB, EBRD, etc., there is long-term funding available. What are the implications for Greece? One first point is that this region, as an economic integration prospect for Greece, has opportunities, but not at the level that Greeks thought, say, 10 years ago. Second, proximity, local knowledge, access to markets is extremely important, and the Greek footprint in this region needs to be maintained. But in order to maintain that, banks, but also corporates, business groups need radically to readjust their business model. One final point, which is more generic. It is important for Greece and the Greek policymaking process really to monitor trends on long-term investment for emerging economies, but also broader, because there is an important lesson there. When you attract long-term investment and long-term investors for the private sector, this is really an important path, not the only one, but an important path to regain access to the market. And if this is the challenge for Greece, I think this is an important avenue for the Greek policymaking process to pursue. IFIs are in Greece and they are supporting this dimension in a way, and that will become stronger in the future. Thank you.